Hello everyone, welcome back to my YouTube channel. I am Pallavi, Assistant Professor of Management. Today I am going to discuss about different research approaches. Okay? In my previous research methodology sessions, we have discussed about meaning, definition, scope and types of research. Now in this video, we are going to discuss about the different approaches of the researchers. What are they? Let us see. Different approaches. So we are going to see the different approaches. How many types of approaches are there in the research? Okay. There is a one quantitative approach, the other one is qualitative approach. There are only two approaches. One is quantitative approach, another one is qualitative approach. We have already discussed in our previous video how quantitative type of research is there and what is the qualitative type of research, which is similar concept is applicable here also. But while doing research, where we will apply certain kind of, you know, approach to our research, which are applicable to the title or topic or the subject under study or a situation under study. So we decide whether we want to follow the qualitative approach or we have to follow the quantitative approach. Let us discuss the first one, that is quantitative approach. Okay, quantitative approach is something where we have already seen that quantity is nothing but numbers. The data which can be expressed in terms of numbers or measurable data, so we call it as a quantitative approach. Okay, we want to study the number of application downloaded, okay, through your Play Store, okay, or number with the number of or else one more topic, a comparative study of number of apps downloaded through your Play Store versus app downloaded to iStore. Okay, so these two things which we want to compare. So the data would be available in numbers, right? It is not available as an opinion or a feeling. So data would be available as a number. So here it says that it involves the generation of data in quantitative form, that is nothing but numbers, measurable number form, which can be subject to quantitative analysis by using mathematics or statistics. If you are analyzing quantitative analysis, we call it as a quantitative analysis. So data collected or information collected should be applied. We can convert it into numbers, or the data collected or information collected is directly in numbers, and we use those numbers and analyze those numbers by using statistical or mathematical methods, then it is called as a quantitative approach. Okay, this quantitative approach further classified into three things. First one is inferential statistics. Inferential statistics means collecting the data from the mass. Say for example, you want to know that whether people are liking to shop in XYZ mall. Okay. Since I am from Bangalore, I would say that the popular mall, Orion Mall. Okay, when I assign this task to my student, he or she will stand in the entry of mall and they try to calculate. They want to know about the whether the people are liking to shop in Orion Mall or. Okay, so then they will go for. One technique which is called as random selection of 100 people who are coming first to the mall, and they collect the opinion from those people whether they like it or not. So how it is now calculated? I have selected a mall called Orion Mall. Okay, now I want to collect the data whether they like the shopping in this particular mall or not. So I have decided that first 100 members who visit the mall, shopping mall, from them I would collect the data. Okay, now they will answer in yes or no. Let us assume they'll answer in yes or no. They like shopping in Orion Mall or they doesn't like shopping in Orion Mall. So in yes or no, we will you know, now we collect it through it as a number. Then we analyze it by applying frequency analysis. then we apply it in a table, we put it in a tabulation, then we put it in a graph or charts, then we draw conclusion with the help of those graphs or charts. So this is inferential statistics. Okay, so collecting the information from mass, the best example would be the census conducted by the government is an inferential approach. They collect the information from each year, family and usual in the country, and according to which they again they classify it to male, female, age from 1 to 5, 5 to 10, 10 to 15, okay, senior citizens, adults. So like this, they are going to categorize it for to take certain decisions, right? So next one is next type of quantitative method approaches, experimental approach. In experimental approach, it is like, remember your chemistry labs, okay? So there is, I'm just giving, I don't know much about chemistry. So I'm giving an example. There are two utensils, I call flask, something which is available. Now you want to experiment the effect of this liquid to this liquid, right? So now you try and error, like you are trying different variables, x variable and y variable, okay? What happens if x is put into y flask? So what is the quantity you have to put? When it is put in a minimum quantity, what is the reaction? When it is put in a maximum quantity, what is the reaction? When it is put in the optimum quantity, what is the reaction? So we are manipulating or administering this x and y variable. So when a dependent variable and independent variable, okay, let us take business example to get into detail. Our famous example, always price and demand, right? Easy to understand. Price and demand, x and y. Okay, when x increases, y decreases. Okay, so now I want to know that how much x I can increase. Okay, whether I can increase to the maximum or to the minimum, how y would react when I increase maximum, this will decrease to the maximum. When I increase to minimum, the price increase to minimum, the demand would be increased to the minimum. Like that, we can manipulate the variables and observe the effect of these things. Okay, effect of these things. I'm talking about quantity here, price in terms of number only, right? Like 10 rupees or 100 rupees. Demand is in the terms of number only, like 1 unit or 2 unit or 3 unit, like that. Okay, so it is about the manipulation of the numbers, variables in terms of numbers, so that I can understand the how dependent variable would react to the our manipulation. Okay, next one is simulation approach. Simulation approach means creating a exact kind of situation where the customer could be studied. Like simulation is an artificial environment which looks like exactly the same as the a real environment. Okay, creating the real environment. You might have seen like farming, right? Farming in a natural environment that would be created like a greenhouse environment, or in lab they would be growing certain kind of seeds and they want to see the reaction. So they create exact kind of farming environment in the lab. Okay, so to test the different kind of factors, maybe humidity, watering, temperature, this how it is reacting to the crop. Okay, so we are creating a same kind of environment, like your chemistry lab, physics lab is also an example. Various different experiments you conducted, that is an example for your simulation studies, like your driving schools, your pilot training centers. So they create simulation of an aeroplane to train you, or simulation of a car to train you in the driving school, right? So how the reactions are happening to achieve the goal, which is called a simulation approach of the research. Okay, now come to the second type, that is qualitative approach. Things which cannot be studied by measurable numbers, measurable quantity or measurable numbers, that is called as qualitative approach. While discussing about the types of approach, I was saying that it is about attitude, study of attitude, behavior, perception, Okay, it's about the opinion feelings. So if you're collecting the data which are related to these type of study, okay, let's say for example, consumer perception towards or students' perceptions towards online classes, right? That is you. This is an opinion or a feeling of students you want to collect. Okay, there are different methods to collect this kind of data, but these are not numerical data. These are the feelings of the student. These are the opinion of the student. So you have to collect it through the different methods which are available to collect the qualitative data. So qualitative data is like exploratory research. We know the facts, but we want to understand the facts, to understand more about the existing knowledge, right? And we want to understand the reasons, opinions, and the motivational, okay? Motivations for particular behavior, whether the customers are buying your product or the customers are not buying your product. We have to understand the motivation behind buying or not buying your product. That is a qualitative approach to your research, okay? Then it will give us an insight to the problem by developing different kind of ideas and hypothesis. Okay, this qualitative data, which is again we can convert it into quantitative data by coding, by giving artificial numbers to the qualitative data. How can we number the attitude or a behavior or a perception? It is an artificial numbers for the purpose of statistical analysis. We assign the numbers, which is called as coding. Okay, we can code the data, qualitative data into code the da qualitative data and convert it into quantitative data for the statistical or mathematical analysis. Okay, it's about the opinion and thoughts and the attitude or perception which we are going to collect for the qualitative data or in qualitative approach. So we have studied about quantitative approach, that is it is measurable in terms of numbers, and we have studied second type of approach, that is qualitative approach, which cannot be measured, which cannot be measured in numbers. Okay, but we can convert them into numbers. Okay, these are the qualitative data are opinion, feelings, and attitude of the which we are collecting. In quantitative data, we are collecting directly the number, and inferential data is something which is like we are collecting a mass data like census, or you're collecting how many people are shopping at a mall, how many apps they are downloading from Google Store. So this is inferential data. Experimental data is something that you want to manipulate the dependent variable by changing the independent variable. So you're experimenting different things and seeing the result which is happening on the other dependent variable. Okay, simulation approach is creating this similar environment where we can test our variables. So this is about your approach to research. Okay, thank you for listening to me. Please subscribe for more content on commerce and management subjects. Thank you.